Hey guys, it's JT, and welcome back to another episode of Doki Doki Literature Club. Natsuki hates me, I'm romancing Yuri properly, and Sari went home and Natsuki's judging me for it. And second, she's kind of been avoiding me today, so I didn't want to force it. Huh? That curious expression coming from Yuri of all people? Calm down, guys. I talked to her earlier and everything's fine. What did she say? Anyway, we need to figure out the rest of the festival preparations, so that doesn't answer my question, Monika. Let's decide what everyone will be doing this weekend. I already know what I'm doing. That's right. Natsuki will be making cupcakes. Ooh, yay. But we might need a lot of them, and different flavors. Can you handle that all by yourself, Natsuki? Challenge accepted. And as for myself, I'm going to be printing and assembling all the poetry pamphlets. Sari will be helping me design them. And as for Yuri... Yuri, you can, Guys, can you help me come up with something for Yuri?
I'm useless.
No, that's not it at all. You're the most talented person here, you know. Jeremy. Now Natsuki's pouting too?
Jeez, even I can tell now. I guess I never gave Sari enough credit, but I can tell things are even harder on you when she's not around.
That may be the case. But if I can't also be a leader on my own, then I won't grow as a person. So, Yuri, you have beautiful handwriting, you know? So you should make some banners and decorations to help set the atmosphere.
Atmosphere? About that, I love atmosphere.
Yuri's expression suddenly changes as she stares at her desk in focus and starts nodding to herself.
Your mind is already racing, I see.
That's great.
Excuse me.
You'll be wonderful help, Yuri. But anyway, that just leaves you, JT.
The one who is truly useless.
Don't say that. In fact, both Natsuki and Yuri have some pretty heavy tasks to handle. I would probably go a long way to give one of them a hand. You could always help me out as well. I would be really appreciative of that. Is Monika suggesting I spend the weekend with one of my club members? How on earth are they going to respond to a suggestion like that?
I suppose I wouldn't mind a bit of help.
Well, even if you don't know how to bake, there's always some dirty work I could give to you. It's not like Monika's gonna give me a choice, and you shouldn't be sitting on your butt anyway.
Natsuki tried to mumble a bunch of excuses like that.
If I recall, Natsuki, you mentioned that you would like to handle the baking on your own. JT might not like to be around if you only make him out to be a nuisance, so therefore, he may be more suited to assisting with the decorations.
Hold on, I never said that. How hard could it be to make a few decorations anyway? Sounds more like you're just making excuses for JT to-
What are you saying? It would be extremely meticulous work. And baking isn't?
Just what do you think- Guys. Let's settle down for a moment. In the end, I think it's up to JT to decide how we'd like to contribute. Besides, he hasn't really gotten the chance to spend any time with me yet, you know? So I'm sure he's interested in- You literally just said, I'm surprised as well. Sorry. Was just saying, though. Jeez. Can we just settle this already?
Yeah.
JT, you're okay with this, right? In the end, it's up to you.
Of course.
Very well.
In that case,
everyone looks straight at me. But of course, I'm gonna go with...
Oh, Sari is an option.
Hold on. I'm gonna save... Yes, let's save.
It's always good to save a game.
So I probably don't want to bother Sayori. Monika's like the tutorial person. She's giving me the tutorial, so I don't know why she wants to hang out, but Sayori's helping her. Natsuki hates my guts, so the only logical option would be Yuri. Plus, I'm better at art than I am cooking, so... Real life fun fact about me. So let's go with Yuri. Well, I'd probably be most helpful. Most useful helping out Yuri. Tongue tied.
Me? Are you serious? Why would you?
Natsuki?
I can already tell you're about to say something mean.
No.
I was just saying. I
wasn't gonna say something mean. I was gonna say something horribly mean. There's a difference.
So you'll be helping Yuri then, JT?
Yeah. That's what I'm gonna do.
I'm glad. I have a bad habit of overthinking these sorts of things. so I think your assistance will be very useful. It's great to hear. Natsuki, will you be able to handle the baking yourself?
I mean, yeah. I already said I'd be fine.
Okay, okay. Everyone can tell that Natsuki's feeling a little sour. So, is that everything we needed to go over?
Yeah, that should be about it. You guys excited?
Well, excited might not be the right word, but I suppose I'm looking forward to it a little bit.
Do you feel the same way, JT?
Me? I guess you could say I'm interested to see how it'll turn out.
That's good enough for me. What about you, Natsuki?
Jeremy.
Natsuki?
What? Why is everyone yelling at me? I didn't even do anything.
No, that's not what I meant at all.
Yuri anxiously glances between everyone in the room.
I'm sorry for this. I don't really know why JT picked me. And also, your cupcakes are the best cupcakes I've ever had. They go really well with my tea. And nothing that I do for the event will compare to that, so...
I get it. Kinda surprised, though.
Why?
Well, I'm the one acting immature. I already know that. You're trying to cheer me up all of a sudden.
No, I'm not very good at it. I'm sorry if I said something bad.
Natsuki isn't the only one surprised. Monika and I are also taken aback by Yuri's words. When she already has trouble with words, trying to cheer someone up must be far out of her own comfort zone. But I begin to understand. Yuri was trying to sound like Sayori. Even if it didn't work perfectly, I can tell that she tried to say something Sayori would say at a time like this. Because Sayori always helps everyone smile and feel good about themselves.
No, I kinda appreciated it. Sorry for making a big deal out of nothing. But I'm gonna say this.
Jeremy?
You better bet that my cupcakes are gonna be the best part of the whole event.
I believe you.
Yeah. I hope to see everyone do their best. But with that, there's nothing more for today. So I guess it's time for us to head out.
Alright, let's get out of here then. It's GTFO, baby. Everybody packs up their things. I start to follow Monika and Natsuki out of the door as they chat between each other.
Hey?
I turn around.
Sorry. I realize I don't have any way of contacting you this weekend.
Oh, you're right. I can't believe this slipped my mind. Should I give you my phone number?
I think that would be the best way, yes?
Alright then. Yuri and I exchange phone numbers.
Okay. Then I'll be stopping by your house on Sunday.
Eh? My house?
Is that a problem?
No, not at all. I just thought I'd be the one going to your house since I'm the one helping you.
I suppose that makes sense. But if you don't mind, I think I would prefer going to your house.
Alright. In that case, it won't be a problem. I decide not to press Yuri for a reason. It's not like it should matter either way, so I just need to make sure my room is clean. I hope I managed to make myself useful in some way. I'm not nearly as creative as you are.
Don't underestimate yourself, JT. I think that will make a very productive team. Even if you only chose me because you felt bad or something.
Wait, you don't actually think that, do you?
Jeremy, I don't know. It's difficult to come up with any other reason you may have chosen me.
You're forgetting the one reason with the most common sense. I literally picked you because logic states you're the most logical answer. I chose to help you because that's what I want to do.
But...
Yuri thinks to herself with an extremely tense expression. Yuri, you're overthinking this. You wanted me to point out when you're overthinking, right?
I didn't realize.
I'm telling you, I want to. That's all there is to it. Do you believe me?
I...
Yuri thinks really hard again. She looks straight into my eyes for a long while. She's staring into my soul.
I believe you.
As if it took her tremendous effort, Yuri finally says that and relaxes her expression.
And I'm really looking forward to Sunday.
Yeah, I am too. After that exchange, I make my way out the door and Yuri follows.
I can't believe this. Yuri's gonna be coming to my house on Sunday?
My anxiety shoots through the roof, as if it wasn't already there. Even though I've gotten pretty used to handling her at this point, there's no telling what might end up happening when we're outside of school. More than that, she told me she was looking forward to it.
Is this a chance I have to make something happen between us? Or is it too early for that?
Oh god, only time will tell. Oh god, I'm freaking out! Ah! But until then, I won't be able to take my mind off of it. I seriously can't wait!
Alright, we don't have to make a poem.
It's already Sunday! I've been standing out in the middle of the street! What have I been doing? It's already Sunday! I've been getting increasingly anxious about Yuri's upcoming visit. I keep telling myself there's no reason to be nervous, but it doesn't help much. Yuri is clearly an introvert and also an intimate person in general. There's no doubt she'll open up a little bit when it's just the two of us. Meanwhile, we've been texting occasionally. She was extremely apprehensive at first, but it wasn't long before I was already learning more about her. But putting Yuri aside, I haven't heard a thing from Sayori since she left club early the other day. It's not like we text each other all the time or anything, but I've been worried about her in the back of my mind. Between what Sayori said and what Monika said, is it really okay for me to put Sayori's feelings aside when she might need me? I decide to visit Sayori before Yuri comes over. Hey, we're gonna look out for our friend. Rather than asking, I simply tell her I'm coming over, much like we've done in the past. Once I reach Sayori's house, I knock on the door before entering myself. Again, we used to play so often that we made it a habit of simply entering each other's houses like we were family. The house is quiet. Sayori isn't anyone on the first floor, so I assume she's up in her room. It's already strange of her to not run down and greet me. I head up to her bedroom, where I finally find her. Ooh, nice room. Sayori?
Hey, GT.
I sit down in her room. Sayori forces a smile, but it's easy to tell that she's different. There's a minute of silence between us.
You haven't come over like this in a long time, have you?
I guess you're right. It's been a long time. It's been a while. Not much has really changed, has it? Sayori's room is as messy as it's always been. I also recognize the same stuffed animals and wall decorations that she's had for years now. Oh yeah, the one calendar with a little bit of writing on it. Yeah, look at all of these posters on this empty wall. Oh, man.
If you came over more often, it wouldn't be such a mess.
That's because I end up cleaning it for you.
How come you suddenly want to come over today? Are you supposed to see Yuri today?
Wait, how'd she know? Yeah, but wait, how'd you know that? Sayori had already left by the time we decided that last meeting.
Monika told me. It's only natural for her to keep me informed about the festival preparations, right?
That's true. But what about you? Are you just going to be aren't you going to be helping Monika? My freaking tongue. It's not working today. Aren't you going to be helping Monika today?
Of course. But I'm just helping her online. We didn't plan to meet up or anything.
So it's just me and Yuri then.
Yep.
There's more silence between us. Sayori stares in a random direction.
What's over here?
Everything about her behavior is really uncharacteristic. I finally get to the point. I want to see how you were doing. After you left on Friday. When something's wrong, you can't hide it from me. I know you too well. So, Sayori smiles, shaking her head.
That's no good, JT.
Eh?
Why can't it just be like what it's always been?
Well, you're suddenly depressed, and I want to know what happened.
It's all my fault. If I didn't get so weak and accidentally express my feelings, if I didn't make that stupid mistake...
You're not stupid, Sayori. What the hell, man?
Then you wouldn't have been worried about me at all.
Okay, look. We're gonna continue this emotionally charged conversation next time on Doki Doki Literature Club. So that's because that's all the time I have for this episode. Thank you guys so much for watching. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe if you want to. It's entirely up to you. And I shall see you all in the next episode where we hopefully comfort Sayori. Alright, see you guys in the next episode. Goodbye.